keep in mind that everything, all is light, true light. And what we try to do is we try to freeze the light down. Imagine water vapor. Cool it down, becomes water. Cool that down, becomes ice cube. Cool that down, becomes what? Cool that down even more and more and more and more. We try to condense, solidify, freeze, contract the light down to such an extent that it becomes something other than light. God is the light. Love is the light. Truth is the light. The light is the light. We've tried to condense it down into something so it's no longer the light. All right. But it still is the light. Keep in mind also that when we want to worship time, what is worshiping of time? We believe that there's a process taking place wherein the light can become the dark, something different than what it is, process. So we need, there's a linked process here where light is actually becoming something else. It just takes time. We have to wait. So we believe there's such a thing as time, where something's happening. There's nothing happening to light. There's no time in which something is happening to light, actually. It's simply light. We asked it to condense, as it were. So it's condensing because we want it, asked it to. And more and more and more condensing. But it's still responding to what we asked it to do. It's still light. Now, when we worship something, an idol, worship time, what are we saying? We're saying, I want you to be forever. Time, I want you to be forever. So we want this to be forever. We want it to be forever. Now, is it forever? Or is our desire that it be forever what's in play here? What's in play, actually? It's very important. When we worship time, time seems to be endless. Right? But what is it that's endless? Is it not our desire that time be endless that's in play? So, how long does time last? It lasts as long as our desire to worship it lasts, right? So when people say, well, it's going to take a long, long time. Really? How about when we get tired of a long, long time? How about when we get tired of worshiping time? How long does time have then to play out? It only plays out as long as we desire that it plays out. Because it's really not there at all. There isn't any process taking place. There's only light. There's only light. There is no process. And light always responds instantaneously in the moment, now moment, to what we desire, what we ask it to respond to. There isn't anything else going on. It's just that. So how long does time last? How long does any fantasy last? Well, it lasts as long as we still are worshiping it. When we get tired of it, it's poof, gone. This world is, what is this world? It's a world of drug addicts. It's a world of drug addiction. It's a world of trying to treat sickness. It's a world of trying to make sickness happy. So yeah, I've got all these problems, but I'm taking this medicine. I feel great. This is the world. This is why people come here. That's why we come here. The light is so condensed here. We think, wow, this is like a different realm. It's a different realm. All these realms and dimensions are just different condensations of this light responding to our desire. But light is totally free. It's totally uncaused. Totally uncaused. It's totally formless. Totally formless. Totally uncaused. Totally free. It never loses what it is. even though we ask for appearances of condensation. These are appearances of condensation, of contraction. So this is a planet of drug addicts. That's what it is. Now, there's a high tide of drug addiction in this world, of all types, pharmaceutical. It's a pharmaceutical planet. So I say, okay, don't fight against it. I say, get back to me when you're tired of this drug addiction, and then we'll talk. We don't need to oppose anything that's happening in the world. We don't even need to oppose the world. I say to world, world, when you're tired of being a world, get back to me when you're tired of being a world, and then we'll talk. Then we'll talk. So light doesn't force issues. It just says, look, when you're tired of what you're doing, get back to me, then we'll talk. That applies to the universe too. To this world, to this body, to our experiences, everything. We keep thinking it has some intrinsic duration apart from our desire. There is no such thing as intrinsic duration apart from our desire that it be, that we be experiencing. So there's no such thing as time. Time doesn't exist. There is no other power that is holding our experiences for us other than our desire, our will, our desire that we experience it. There is no other force. We're imagining there's some other force that's holding it there. It's not true. There is no such thing as time. Time, space, form, space. There is no power of form, space. No power of time, space. No causation of form, space, time, space. There is no causation. The light is cause-free, it is causeless, it is free of causation. Other than the intrinsic, inherent dynamic that is God. The inherent responsiveness to our desire for experiencing. So I'm trying to talk, as the light. The light has come. The light has come in a dream last night. I went over the summit of the mountain. It was a dream like here, Highway 17, going over to Santa Cruz. And when you get to the summit, suddenly the entire Monterey Bay is there. And sometimes when it's super calm and not cloudy, the light is reflecting off the ocean. And you see this just lake of gold there, you know. Well, I came over the summit of Highway 17 in the dream, and the light was reflecting off the sea, the ocean. But the light was so bright, the light was so intense, it was so pure. I said, wow, I was in the light. And what I noticed was the kind of the windshield of the car acted as a sunscreen, like a sunglasses, and it stepped down the intensity of the light so that I could stand it. But it was still, the light was so bright that everything, the landscape disappeared, form disappeared. There was only just vestigial outlines of form, the road, so I could still drive on the road. But everything else was just in this intense, intense golden light. And I was like, yeah, this is great. This is what I love. This is what I want. I wasn't panicked or shocked or anything. It was just like, I kept driving towards it. I said, yeah. More light. Light. Everything was completely bleached out, all form, completely bleached out. But just enough of the form that I could function, but yet it was totally bleached out with light, everything all form bleached. Imagine pouring just this little golden bleach over everything, or just bleached out, total. Everything was light, 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 light. Everything looked like this. Okay, I just got a knock. There's a knock at the door, and I came out of here and I went around. Usually I don't. I ignore it because I'm taping. I said, you know, this time I'm going to go and do the courtesy. You know, I don't know who, maybe it's a friend. I don't know. I don't have any friends come to the door, but so it was someone canvassing for a political candidate. And he said, hey, I said, look, I can't, I don't have time to deal with this. And he said, that's okay. And I said, oh, okay, just you're going around for the candidate. I said, that's great, that's fine. I took the information. I said, thank you very much for your time and, you know, coming by. And he says, hey, you know, this candidate supports light rail. See, that's all he said. He said, this candidate supports light rail. I support light rail. light rail. And on his back, on his shirt, as he left, it said Skycraft. It said Skycraft. Ah, my gosh, I support light. I support light rail, too. I support the rail that goes into the light. I'm very supportive of light rail. Light, 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 like that. The light has a voice. It can speak. It has an intelligence. It can talk to us. The light can talk to us. We can allow the light to speak to us, actually. It's just the light. Uncaused light. Unblocked light, unchanged light. It is the light. It is the light. That is all that there is. Light from light, light from light, light from light. So we have this world of drug addiction. What do? Do we fight against it? Do we struggle against it? Do we say, let's just denounce it? No, because they're going to do it anyway. Because they think, they say, no. They say the light is sick, but we're going to heal it. We're going to treat it. We're going to treat the sickness. The light is sick. They don't recognize that it's our own desire to condense the light that caused the condensation. They think the light condensed on its own. This is not true. It was our desire of spirit telling the light we want to create separate from God. So give us this illusion of separation that's caused this condensation of light, the appearance of condensation. It's just all an appearance that seems to be bound by time. It's not bound by any time. It's bound by our desire and nothing else. So the world is saying, no, light is sick. We need to treat it. So we say, light, give us all these sick forms so we can treat these sick forms and be greater than the light, you see. We're going to heal God. We're going to heal the light. So this is a fantasy that spirit is playing out. So we have to let it play out until they get sick and tired of being sick and tired, which they certainly will. But you see, in their boastfulness and their worshiping of time, they insist it's going to take a long time. So light says, look, when you're sick and tired of time, get back to me. Then we'll talk. That's all that light says. Get back to me and we'll talk. When you're sick and tired of what you're doing, then get back to me and we'll talk. No problem. But what the people say here is, oh, really? Well, it's going to be a long time. You're going to be waiting a long, long time, billions and trillions of years, and maybe you'll have to wait forever. If a light is not bluffed by this, bluff says, okay, get back to me when you're tired of forever, of waiting forever. Okay, another political canvasser. They just left something there. They didn't knock. Okay, the light rail did knock. The one that says, I support light rail, knock. This one just left something. I wonder what they left. It's very important to hear this, that the world is bluffing. The world is saying, no, we love what we're doing. We're healing the light. We're healing the light. And light says, get back to me when you're tired of healing the light. Okay, then we'll talk. And they say, that'll take a long time. And you'll be changed. You'll be healed by then. We won't need to get back to you. Get back to me when you're tired of trying to heal the light. When you're tired of healing the light, get back to me. We'll talk. Again, worshiping time. We don't realize it's our desire. And we think that time is external, some external power that is eternal. And so we think it'll last forever or last a long time. And so when someone says, well, get back to me when you're tired of this, you say, what are you talking about? That's going to be so long. No, it isn't. Because as we get tired of sickness, our desire begins to change. And then we say, hey, I don't think this is going to last very long. It seems like it's evaporating. I think I'm going to take light up on its offer. This is how it works. So light doesn't force itself on anyone. It just says, hey, when you're tired of being tired, get back to me. When you're tired of drug addiction, get back to me. When you're tired of worshiping time, let's talk. Let's talk then. Okay, no problem. And you think, well, light doesn't like me. It doesn't want to talk now. It's going to be a bit bored waiting for me. No. We do get tired of this nonsense. And we say, hey, light, I'm kind of tired of time. Can we talk? And light says, sure, let's talk. I love it when I hear light talk. It's the greatest thing, greatest ever. It's better than any music. It's the greatest song there is when light is talking to me. I just listen and I say, wow, love it. Love it. Light said, hey, world, get back to me when you're tired of being a world. Then we'll talk. Love it. It's not bluffed by the world. It's not bluffed by the universe. It's not bluffed by any of that at all. And light will talk that way to you. You'll hear that these thoughts will occur to you. These thoughts will occur. It's just like, wow, I love it. I love that way of thinking. I love those thoughts like that. Get back to me when you're tired of thinking, and then we'll talk. So we're so interested in being heroes and heroines, and heroin addicts too. Heroin addicts, actually, is what we're into right now. The world's into heroin addiction, actually. So when we get tired of heroin addiction, then light says, get back to me then, we'll talk then. We'll talk then, no problem. You don't want to talk now, no problem. We'll talk then. That's like that. So, I've turned a corner, and it was a dream of light that did it. And I just went into this incredibly intense light. I saw it in its purity, and it was actually so pure. It was clear light, totally clear light. Okay, first I saw this totally clear light, which all form vanished, as it were. And then I said, wow, okay. But that's a little too intense. I said, okay, it's a little intense as far as functioning here. And then I saw the light gradually stepping down, as if I had put on sunglasses or a camera. When it's, you know, auto exposure, it'll step, if it's too bright, it'll step it down, like that. And it got stepped down in maybe five different steps, actually. Called the fifth dimension. Five different steps removed from the pure, clear light. That's what I experienced. And I said, yeah, okay, I can function with this level of light here. But I rehearsed, practiced, rehearsed, oriented yourself to the light, and done all the spiritual work. If you're going into this light like that, you might start looking for darkness and clinging to that, you know, looking. No, I didn't do that. I just said, oh, this is great. I love it. More light. I said, you don't have to step it down. I said, I realized, well, you know, it's easier to function here if it's stepped down a little bit like that. I love the light. Love the light. Let it be brighter and brighter and brighter and brighter. And even then to the clear light is so bright it's actually totally clear. That's its true form. The true form, it's truly formless. Its true light is completely formless. The light that we see, electromagnetic radiation, is actually extremely frozen, condensed appearance of this light, of the formless light. The sunlight, electromagnetic radiation, all this extremely, extremely frozen and condensed down to the ultimate extent, so to speak. Yeah. So the light that I was seeing was costless. It was everywhere. It was just the whole sky, atmosphere, everything was saturated with light. With this golden light. Like this. But I was just driving towards it. Yeah, this is great. Love it. There's no fear. I didn't experience any fear. I was kind of like saying, okay, am I driving? Can I stay on the road? Am I driving? But I said, yeah. Okay, no problem. So this light can talk to us, actually. It can use words, it can speak to us, it can speak. This morning I was just listening to the thoughts of this light, you know. I say, what's your thoughts about this and this and this? And I said, oh, I love it. And it just said, hey, you don't want to talk now? We'll talk later. That's fine. Just leave it at that. So yeah, the planet right now, hell-bent on drug addiction, fine. When you're tired of drug addiction, light said, get back to me then and we'll talk. It's just like that. So we don't have to try and change the world or fight against it. Because the light has stepped down many steps, okay? And in each one of those steps, there's an entire domain, an entire realm of that quality of light. We don't have to remain in this extremely frozen electromagnetic realm of addiction, drug addiction, time worshiping, all that. Not at all. It's like this. Let's step the light down here, the exposure, you see, it can go like that, all right? The light here is the same, okay? The camera is not picking it up, but I assure you, the lighting has not changed where I am, okay? Not in the slightest bit. So now, let us step the light up gradually like this, and we think, oh, The light is increasing. This is nice. The light is increasing. And you step it up like this, step by step by step. And then to the highest step like this. But the lighting is exactly the same. It hasn't changed in the slightest bit. It's our exposure to it. We shut our exposure down to it in the camera. Camera is perception. So perception can seem to shut down light. It doesn't. It's only shutting down its exposures. Imagine exposure to it. Okay. So when we shut our exposure down to the max, we get this. We get this, you know. And then we think, oh, the light is not light anymore. We need to heal the light. And so we can play God. At this level, we get to play God. At least, play God. Like a fantasy of God, you know. But all the while, the light is this, you see. It's all the while. It's this. So we get to play at this realm, this super, super condensed. Playing God seems to be, you know, we're able to say, wow. Look at this. This isn't light, it's sickness, it's darkness. We get to bring the light to darkness. Now even the darkest darkness is light. Totally. 100%. So light says when you get tired of playing God, let's talk. Let's talk. We'll talk then. We'll talk then. There's no rejection. Light doesn't reject anyone. I say, God, but I'm totally into all this, you know. I say, light, I'm totally into all this God addiction, playing God. I want to play God. And light says, fine, whatever, you know. You don't want to talk now? We'll talk later. That's fine. When you're tired of the scheme you're playing, then we'll talk. Light doesn't argue. It doesn't argue. You either listen or you don't want to listen. If you don't want to listen, light says, fine. That's fine. When you're ready to listen, then I'll talk. I'll let you know what's what. Now, if the light, you say, well, it's too bright. Okay. All right, we step it down just a little bit here. All right, we'll step it down a couple stops. Like that. Let's see if I can... So we say, okay, we can help, we can function with that. But we're aware that it's stepped down by our desire. Okay, because the continuity fear, we're afraid of the clear light, actually. Ultimate form of light is this clear light. We're afraid of that because the continuity issue we're used to, you know, the darkness. So what we do is we step the light up like this, you know, gradually, sort of like this. Oh, it's nice. Oh, it's getting brighter and brighter and brighter. And then finally like that, and we get it real, real bright if it's like that, okay? And so we step it up from the dark. Gradually we turn the corner. So we're like this. Right now we're like this. We're addicted to playing God, thinking we need to heal the light, bring light to the light. And then we turn the corner like this, and then we start to see, ah, the light. And then we step it down a little bit like this. And then gradually we don't need to be stepped down so much, and it can be like this. And then ultimately it's simply clear light. No perception required. So this is what's happening. I had to get the light by June 1st, and it came in a dream, right on time. See, it's amazing. And I wasn't bothered by it at all. In fact, I said, more, come on. This is great. But of course, it takes a little getting used to, so light understands that, so get used to it. Maybe we have some time to get used to it, a couple years maybe, I don't know how long. The rapture, the ascension, all of that, how's that play out? I don't know, but I tell you for sure that these different realms of light do exist. We're told that we can actually be translated from this realm of severe darkness into a lighter realm. We can be literally bodily translated. That's what we've been told. I don't see any reason why we cannot. You said at the end times that we'll be turned into bodies of light. Okay, why not? Absolutely. Light bodies. But this is just a reflection of our desire, again, to listen to light and understand his explanation for what's taking place. Lose our fear of formlessness. Gradually. So, of course, something could something along those lines could occur. I'm not saying it will, or I'm not saying it will not. It's entirely possible, though. It's been impressed upon me from many different angles that we have several years to overcome our fear of light. Now, how we help with this? We're helped by this by those in the world who have overcome their fear of light. That's how we're helped here. And by our own desire to listen to light. We're tired of playing doctor to light, you know, trying to heal the light, trying to play God. Oh, you know, like, whoa, something wrong with God, something wrong with the light. The light is God. So we say, there's something wrong with the light. It's gone dark, but we're going to heal it. We're going to bring light to the light. We're tired of that nonsense, right? So it's our own desire is evaporating. And therefore, we are, you know, eager for the light. Like me, I'm super eager for it. My whole life, I've been eager for it. What do? You hang out around those who are certain. No doubt. You hang around those who have no doubt about it. That's your crowd. So that's what I've done. Who have I hung out with? Jesus. Jesus Christ. No doubt whatsoever in Jesus Christ. I hang out with Buddha. No doubt whatsoever with Buddha. Hang out with Ramana Maharshi. No doubt whatsoever in Ramana Maharshi. Hang out with Nisargadatta Maharaj. No doubt whatsoever in Nisargadatta. Hang out with Sri Anandamayi Ma. No doubt whatsoever in Sri Anandamayi Ma. You see? That's my crowd. That's been my crowd. So those are the ones that I hang out with. And there are many others too that I hung out with a little while too. Many others. But those five are like the major ones, I would say. Hang out with a little bit with Mary Baker Eddy, Christian Science. Absolutely. Krishnamurti. Absolutely. Murray Watts, You Are the Splendor. Had the vision of light. Tremendous, tremendous light. Murray Watts. No doubt there. Very unknown, though. And many, many others, non-dualists, you know, of all different types, all different teachers. That's my crowd. I just hung out. I want those who have no doubts. No doubts, no doubts. So that's how you get your own doubts evaporated. So right now we need to ascend. We don't need to. We can if we want to. This planet is going into this very much this they want, in order to play God, you've got to go into this, okay, really severe darkness. So you can say that God is sick and then we're going to heal God. The reason why we think we can't heal God yet is because God isn't sick enough. You know, we haven't made God sick enough to accept the remedy, we think. So we try to make it darker and darker and darker and darker and darker. Black hole. We want to go into this black hole. Let me say, God, you're a black hole, and now we're going to bring the light to you. You see? Never works, because leaving the black hole is the light of God. Responding to our desires that we play this game. So those of us who realize this and have lost our fear of the light to some extent, hanging out with these no doubters, Sri Nisargadatta Maharaj is a very wonderful no-doubter. people came to him and said, "Hey, Sri, you know, I've got doubts." And he would just say, "You got doubts? Great. I don't have any doubts." And they say, "Well, how do I resolve my doubts?" He says, "Come on over and see things from my perspective, and then tell me if you have any doubts." Just like that. It's every question would say, "Hey, I've got this doubt." They bring up, "Hey, I've got this doubt." He says, "I don't have that doubt." And they say, "Well, what about this one?" He says, "I don't have that one either." "Well, surely you have this doubt. I mean, everyone has this doubt." He says, "No, I don't have that one. I don't have any doubts." Love it. Love it. Love it. To be around someone like that, it would be so fantastic, you know. Just so that's how we get our doubts evaporated. We start to realize, hey, it's okay, you know. We don't have to play God. We don't have to fix the light. It's not broken. It's not broken. They say everything's perfect. And Sri Ananda Maimadi has come to us and say, "Hey, Ma, I got all these doubts. There's war. Look at this. I mean, this, wow. You know, she's, the world's so terrible." She says, "No, what are you talking about? The world's perfect. Everything's perfect. Everything's completely perfect." Totally blessed. Everything's perfect. look at it from my perspective. You'll see everything's perfect. Absolutely perfect. The light is perfect. There is no other force that's come in and has changed the light. It's all simply reflecting our desires perfectly. That's what she's saying. It's reflecting perfectly our desires. There's no problem. There is no problem. Everything's perfect. No doubts. This is it. Hang out with these folks. Hang out with these folks. Well, how do we get ready to at least come into greater light? The planet thinks it's coming into greater light because it thinks it's figuring out how to heal the light. This is not true. The planet is deluded. Okay, the people, the mindset of this world is extreme delusion. High, extreme delusion. And they think we finally figured out what's wrong with the light. We finally figured out how to fix it. We got these, you know, high, you know, particle colliders in the mountains and the Swiss Alps. We got all these, you know, HARP, and we're figuring out. We said we're finally figuring out how to heal the light. This is the mindset. It's total delusion. Okay, total delusion. The light is not sick. It's our desires for sickness that is causing the reflection. The light to appear, reflection, to appear the way everything is appearing to us. So they think they've got it figured out. They're going to be God. They're going to fix the light. So they think everything's going to be great. As soon as we fix the light, we got a golden age here. Utter total delusion. They're going into a black hole. That's what's happening. At least some, that mindset for sure. Now, for those who the opposite say, no, I realize I've hung out with the right crowd, so I don't have this fear. I've been able to see it correctly. Well, they're going to greater light. How do we get dropped in the next couple years? How do we do this? Hanging out with the right crowd, I would say. How's that possible? It seems impossible, doesn't it? Well, light reflects our desires. So when we truly desire this, this is what light will provide for us. See, for me, I say, I don't know how I'm going to do that. I seem to be in a black hole of debt, and I can't move. I have no work. Going deeper and deeper into debt, all this. Okay, so I said, but I said, I don't worry about it. I said, okay, I keep working on, this is what I want. This is what I desire, to hang out with the right crowd. Be part of the right crowd, the light crowd, the true light crowd, where our fear of the light dissolves. And, oh, we say, well, Sri Nanaima, Ramaharshi, and Sargadatta, Jesus, Buddha, everyone, they're not here, but the light is here. The light is always here. There's only the light, so the light is here. So the light can appear whenever, however it appears. That's not a problem. If our desire is for that. Let me see if I can. Okay, got it. Got the stuff off the screen just like that. Okay, see? Got rid of the debt somehow. So I'm fired up with light to be part of that. That's very different than the other crowd who thinks that they're healing the light, because they're fired up too. They're fired up and they got their song and dance going, you know. They got their bureaucracy going. They're gonna crush the opposition. They're ready. Okay, so they're ready to go into their black hole for sure. And the light says, let them go, it's okay. They'll get tired of it. Light says, don't worry, they'll get tired of it. And as soon as they get tired of it, then we'll talk. Just like that, they will get tired of it. Don't worry. I tested out the entire situation here, down to utter chaos. And I've seen, yes, at that point you get tired of it instantly. Once you reach the bottom, you bottom out, you instantly get tired of it. Your desire begins to evaporate instantly. So there is no way that anyone will be lost forever like that. It's impossible. They get tired of it, for sure. Light knows this. It's not concerned at all. God is not concerned. Light is not concerned. He just says, look, they'll get tired of it. Don't worry. Much quicker than you realize. Much quicker. Let them have their fun and games. Let them do whatever they want to do. It's not a problem. Not a worry. Now, those who are in other realms of light, less condensed light perhaps, they are worried and concerned because the manipulation of electromagnetism somehow is affecting their realm. That's why we've had there has been a lot of those from other dimensions, so to speak, of light, upset with what, you know, the atomic energy and what this, the pollution of this planet. They're upset. They say, hey, it's bugging us, you know, it's causing us problems. It could cause a lot of problems for us. So that's the problem. That's their delusion. What they need to do is step up into lighter light, as it were. Less occluded light. It's only their desire still that light can be sick, that makes them feel that their realm is being affected, can be affected. Shift up to a higher realm, as it were. More light in the realm. So certainly, there's a lot going on here. But again, light is not concerned at the slightest bit. Because ultimately, light is not being affected. Light is not being changed. These various condensations, levels of condensation, can interact with one another. That's also a desire. But no matter what the dance of condensation is, it's still the pure light. It's all just the pure light. There's only pure light and nothing else. Thank you, Longchampa. I forgot to mention Longchampa, but I bring him in now because I've been hanging out also with Longchampa, the great Buddhist radical Dzogchen teacher. Or rather, he's been hanging out with me, but it's mutual. It's mutual. It's mutual. I actually sent a call for help, and that's what showed up. I said, hey, I feel like I'm stuck. Can anyone help me? And this teacher showed up. Just like that. Out of compassion, you know. I said, hey, is there anyone that really cares with compassion? Please, I feel like I just need a boost. Showed up. I said, wow, gave me a tremendous boost. Tremendous boost. Great, 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 great teacher. You know, he's very underappreciated, Longchampa. Certainly Buddhists know Longchampa for sure. Some more than others. But this is a heavyweight teacher. This is one that, as all the teachers, pure light, abides in the pure light. Same with Anandamaya Maha, Ramana Maharshi, Srinasargadatta, Jesus, Buddha, abiding in the pure light. The pure light. And from there, understand, recognizing everything is fine. Everything is perfect, though, no worries. But we understand your continuity problem. They understand our continuity problem. This is key. The continuity problem is key. Otherwise, we'll think that something's wrong with the light. We need to fix it as we go along. We don't need to fix anything except the continuity problem. This is called fast-tracking. The other way is you're just enmeshing yourselves in greater and greater confusion and difficulty, thinking that you need to solve some problems. I don't have any problem except the continuity problem. There are no problems except the continuity problem. That's it. Light doesn't have any problems except the continuity problem, which is merely a pragmatic issue, not an actual issue. It's a pragmatic issue based on our attempt to undo the light. So I don't have a single problem. Nothing needs to be fixed. All the problems have zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the continuity problem is my problem. It's the only problem there is. There is no other problem other than the continuity problem. That's a fact. So that's a statement of fact, very important to state fact. There are no problems except the continuity problem, period. No exceptions. No exceptions. This is an ascension attitude. If you want to know how do I ascend, this is it. Abide in this declaration and you are ascending. I have no problems except the continuity problem. There are no other problems anywhere, in any dimension, any level, any realm. There are no other problems whatsoever except the continuity problem. Period. No exceptions. Because everywhere there's only the reflection of our desire for what we want to experience. There is nothing, no other dynamic whatsoever. And yet, by believing there is another dynamic, we're afraid of recognizing the truth, that we're afraid of the pure light. We feel like it's safer to be in a condensed light, because then we can more easy to think there's some problem. But if we say, no, there are no problems except the continuity problem, which isn't a real problem. There are no problems. It just evaporated naturally. Okay. There are no problems whatsoever, none except the continuity problem. All other problems have zero value to me. Only the continuity problem has value to me. And the vision of oneness is what resolves the continuity problem, which is the vision of formless light. The formless light. Light in its formless. Instead of insisting it reflect itself in terms of form, which can be interpreted as maybe it's sick, maybe it's sick, maybe it's getting sick, maybe something's happening to the light. You see? Nothing's happening to the light. It's our desire that something happened to the light that is playing out in this way. So this is a lovely talk that I hear when I listen to the light. I'm just passing it on here to the world. I just say more and more and more and more and more. I want to hear more. Just keep talking. Come on, come on. Don't stop. Don't stop. This is wonderful. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. And people say, why don't you make a song about it? What do you mean? This is the song. This is the song. It's like taking a lovely, beautiful song and saying, hey, why don't you condense that down into something that's not as lovely? And I say, no. Why don't you develop the ear? When you're ready to listen, this song is here to listen to. When you're tired of listening to the other junk, then we'll talk. Then let's play this song. See, our goal is to go into this light more and more and not get trapped in this, you know, this play of delusional darkness. So I'm not going to be stepping it down too much. You know, that's important. Okay. Sure, it's already stepped down because it's not pure, clear light here. It's words and concepts. But I'm not going to step it down even more, you know, into something else, some other form. Not much, you see, not much. Maybe I'll do something. Who knows what light wants to do? Who knows what light wants to do? Whatever it wants to do is fine. But it's ascension time, okay? Keep that in mind, it's ascension time. And so what this does is it brings this wow feeling to you. More than music, more than music. Music tickles you a lot. You see, this is like, wow. This is the more profound. It's more direct. So it's quicker. More direct route. I've already seen what beautiful music and poetry can do. It's not fast enough for these times. It's not romanticism, beautiful, flowery, musical romanticism. I was an expert in that. It's not quick enough now. It's not quick enough. You know, this is for those who are saying, hey, I'm really tired of trying to fix light. I'm really tired of it. That's what this is for. This is for those who say, okay, this is the end of the age. You say, no, I don't want another cycle. Forget it. No way. So then, you know, let's go fast. Let's hang out with the no-doubters. Just hang out with the no-doubters. And the no-doubters are not mean or anything. You know, that's the thing. It's just like Srina Sargadatta, everyone said, oh, he's fierce. You know, I grew up, I heard stories of him. He's so fierce, you know, scary. You know, and I was scared of him. I said, whoa, no, I don't want to go near this guy. You know, he's mean, he's fierce, he's scary. He's going to, you know, do something terrible. But this is not true at all. He's a pussycat. He's wonderful. I said, well, where did this idea get? He's mean. Where did this come from? It's ridiculous. He's just a no-doubter. He expresses this no-doubt intensely, which is great. So he expresses this very intensely. There's a lot of neighbors around, so speaking softly. They might think I'm like Srina Sargadatta, scare him. Oh, he's so fierce, he's so intense. Light. Oh, it's scary or something. Not scary. It's just our continuity fear talking. Those who have no doubt are full of this wonderful good humor in terms of, sure, you don't want to talk about it, it's fine, that's okay. Whenever, you know, you're tired of this ridiculous, you know, darkness and sickness, and then we'll talk, no problem at all. So how do we ascend? Hanging out with the right crowd is how we do it. Hang out with the right crowd. Now you may have a big crowd that you hang out with, fine. However many, doesn't matter, one or many. You just make sure you're hanging out with the right crowd. If you're hanging out with the right crowd, then you should be able to hang out with these heavyweights. You should be able to say, oh yeah, this is great, no problem. Good feeling. Like for me, Longchenpa, I said, this is wonderful. Love it. Just love it. No problem at all. I said, this is just wonderful. Music to my ears. You know, this is what I want to hear. People say, oh, that stuff is extremely difficult. And it's, yeah, wow, it's really tough. Wow, no, it's music. And beautiful music. It's great. So, just like that. Hang out with the no-doubters. Let the light, hear the light speak to you. Hear the light speak to you. No doubters can let the light speak directly to you. And even there's the presence of this intense light. Seems to be a presence of intense light. Just get used to it, that's all. Just get familiar with it. Just hang out with it. That has its effect. It has its effect. You say, hey, I'm no longer scared. I'm not so scared. This isn't, what's the big deal? It's fine, this is fine. The fears evaporate, gradually evaporate, just like that. Just feel like, it's just this intense evaporation. Love it. Now for a while you might hang out with one and then hang out with someone else and hang out with someone else and hang out, you know. You can bounce around like that. I do that. Sometimes I hang out with Jesus, sometimes with Visargadatta, sometimes with Longchenpa, sometimes with Ramana Maharshi, sometimes with Ramana Mahima, and sometimes with maybe others, or sometimes just straight with the Holy Spirit, straight with the light. Some teachers in the world that some people hang out with. I tend not to get as much light as I want from them, so I prefer to hang out with someone like Longchenpa or Jesus or etc. Like my five key crowds in my crowd. You know, Google has these circles. This is my circle. You know, these teachers are my circle. But if there is some no doubters in the world, that would be great. That'd be great. Maybe there will be. Maybe there'll be, you know, others I want to hang out with. Get a crowd together. Fine, let's do it. I'm all ready to hang out. Ready for the hanging out. Let's hang out together. I like to do it. There's lots of light in the atmosphere too. Light. And it's hot and everything, you feel evaporation taking place. You think, wow, I'm just going to be left with nothing but this light. Yeah, that's great. All this form is just evaporating. It's so hot, it's just all evaporating. I say, yeah, I just let everything just evaporate into formlessness. Let everything just evaporate. Gradually. And as it evaporates, it gets more and more beautiful, more and more beautiful, more and more beautiful. So let all form just begin to evaporate. Begin to see all form evaporating. It doesn't disappear right away. It starts evaporating, right? And becomes more beautiful. The ice cube is now sitting in the water, and you get this glass with the ice suspended in the water, and it's so beautiful, like that. So I got a feeling that something's coming up there. Something's percolating here. Just trust in the light, trust in the desires. The light will reflect the desires, you see, light will reflect the desires. 2-year time period it's coming back in various ways to me. It's very powerful, I got very powerful. The Holy Spirit said, you got 2 years, starting June 1st, I would say. Let's get a march on it, you know, June 1st. So we got a little extra, maybe wiggle room. June 1st, and we want to be done before July of 2016. Okay, we want to be done before July of 2016. July of 2016 is, let's make cutoff time. Mid-July 2016, all right? We want to have lost our fear of at least the next dimension, the next realm, fifth dimension, let's say, the light, and at least be able to ascend to that reflection of light. Or if the world wants to ascend with us, fine, too. That's fine. It's all good. Is that going to happen? It doesn't look that way, does it? No. So we have 2 years from June 1st now. 2 years to get it done. 2 years to get it done. We will get it done. I always get it done. The light gets it done. Maybe we'll take the full time, all right? So by June 1st, let's check in June 1st, 2016, we'll see where we're at with the light. So I'm calling the light down, calling the light now. Light. The light rail guy shows up at the door this morning. But let me see what the other candidate, wait a second. Oh my gosh, very interesting. Someone hung something on our doorknob. And it says, let's keep our high school students on top. And it has this picture of this heroine, like a Statue of Liberty, this young female high school student with her hand up, all dressed in a white gown with her hand up like a Statue of Liberty pose. It says, let's keep our high school students on top. In other words, let's keep heroine worship going. Heroine worship going. Let's keep heroine worship on top. Very funny. Very amusing. That's what's happening. That's the game that's happening here. Heroine worship. Let's keep this plan of fixing light on top. Let's keep this plan of fixing light on top. We have the fixers here now. Don't worry. We have the heroines here. Don't worry. The heroes couldn't quite get it done, but the heroines will get it done. Don't worry. Don't worry, folks. We'll keep this on top. We'll keep this agenda on top. We'll keep the black. We'll keep going into the black hole. Don't worry. No worries. Okay. Light is not concerned. Light laughs and says, when you're tired of heroine worship, well, let's talk. We'll talk then. If you don't want to talk now, we'll talk then. No problem. No problem whatsoever. See, first came the light rail. The skycraft, so to speak. Light rail skycraft. And then, a little later, heroin worship thing. Let's keep our high school students on top of the heroin worshiping. So, we had a little first. So, I say by June 1st, 2016, let's be done. And then July of 2016 comes the let's fix the light thing. The let's fix the light thingy will show up big time some way, right? Now, we had to be ready by this time in order to get into this hangout thing, hanging out with the no-doubters. I've been advocating this my entire life, that you've got to hang out with the no-doubters. And I've tried to put pictures of, these no-doubters up on video. And people, it's kind of like, but now, something, a light has to go off in your life and just say, a light will go off and say, wow, I'm not that afraid. I can hang out with the no-doubters. It's not that threatening. But how will it take place? We'll find out. It's go time now. It's go time. Hangout time. It's hangout time. We're not trying to fix the problems of the world anymore. We understand what that's all about. It's about trying to play God. Dr. God in a white gown. The heroine is here. Don't worry. She knows how to play God. She knows how to fix the light. Okay. Well, that's fine. When they get tired of that game, we're here to talk. We're here to hang out with. That's all. Don't want to hang out with us now? That's fine. Don't want to hang out with the light, the no-doubt light? That's fine. When you want to, I'm happy to hang out. So, events will move rapidly. I don't know how rapidly. I don't care. Whatever happens, happens. Okay, let me get this up. Happy June 1st. Happy 2-year hangout time. That's it.